wrong.
Cara, I wasn't prepared for the emotions I felt seeing you walk towards me earlier. Yeah, walk towards me down the aisle earlier. Yeah, or you. Oh, I love you so much. You look absolutely stunning.
Yeah, in that dress. Possible to divorce on the same day?
I can't believe how lucky I am. I'm unbelievably proud of you. You put so much time and effort into making this day happen. Trying to plan a wedding is hard enough. But trying to do it alongside a house move is another thing. Then to top it off, you find out you're pregnant. Obviously, we all know how that happened.
Mixing bowl.
It just wasn't supposed to happen so soon. This wasn't supposed to happen so soon. I can't help but think I'm partly to blame though. If only I'd put that TV up on the wall sooner, Cara may have left me alone in All jokes aside though, we couldn't be happier. It is a blessing to conceive so naturally, and now our baby is here with us today. Kitchen or right inside your tongue. All the meat bowl in the fridge. I know during the ceremony earlier, Bridget gave a little insight into how me and Cara came about. I'd like to delve a little bit further. Thank you for a walk down memory lane and reminisce on the events that led us to here today. As you know, Cara and I first met in high school. September 1997, to be precise. We didn't have much to do with each other, to be honest. Cara was part of the cool crowd, you see. Stone Martians. Once we're close again, the cool crowd. They could just be found avoiding the teachers, smoking crafty fags behind the leisure centre. I myself was usually found in the canteen, eating cheeseburgers or playing handball with the not so cool crowd. Little did she know the chubby, spotty kid with braces would end up being her husband today. Although we never really crossed paths at high school, I do remember a certain rumour that sparked a bit of intrigue. Psst. Have you heard a car dog has got a nipple pierced? Fast forward 15 years or so later. February 2015. The age of the smartphone and Tinder. The year began as many had before. Single. At the age of 31, still living at home with my parents. Valentine's Day on the horizon, and no love interest to speak of.
Oi!
I focus my attention on the upcoming motocross season and buy myself a brand new motocross bike. Happy days. But lo and behold, a familiar face starts to appear on my Facebook. Cara Doggett likes your photo. Cara Doggett, interesting. I wonder if she's still got that nipple piece. Then in typical Cara fashion, she started the interaction by taking the mick out of me. This interaction continued for several weeks and had escalated into flirty banter. So I arranged to meet for a drink. Friday the 3rd of April, it was Good Friday. We met in one of Stowmarket's more salubrious romantic hotspots, The Oak. There was a good night, several drinks and even a little kiss. Followed by Donna meeting chips. It seems the texty banter had blossomed into romance and I scored another date. As you heard earlier, I managed to reverse into a fence. So things were off to a flying start. It didn't stop there though.
Oh, God.
guys. After our first adult sleepover, we gained a new nickname, kindly given by a maid of honour, Mr. Farty Pants. I'll spare you the details, but needless to say, Cara certainly felt the wind blow through her hair. And I've never been so embarrassed in my life. Anyway, the relationship with Love Kevin. 3.5 years later, we're here today. I never thought it happened to me, but it did. I found my soulmate and gained a daughter and little Debbie. I love you both so much, it's unreal. The love we share has made me a better person. Cara, I'm so proud to be your husband. And Debbie, I love being with you. And soon, our little baby will be here to complete our family. So, before I hand you over to the best man, my last toast of the day to Cara and Debbie.